Today we have Shivita with us, who's doing her studying her medicine, and she will take us through various aspects of preparation for NEET and getting into a medical college. Shivita, please introduce yourself to our audience.
Hello everyone, I'm Shivita Kansar and I'm presently doing my MBBS third year from Army College of Medical Science, New Delhi.
Shivita, to begin with, please tell our students that what are the different exams that they can write to make it to a good medical college.
Okay, so we have this main exam, that is NEET, National Eligibility Conventions exam, and I think AIIMS and JIPMA recently have joined into this NEET only. So there's something less to worry about. We just have one exam, NEET. And after 12th standard, that is physics, chemistry, and biology, three subjects are very important to, get eligibility for this exam. And that is all NEET exam you have to give. So that is important.
Shivita, tell that how did you prepare for your NEET exam, because you got a very good ranking. So please share some strategies with our children.
Okay, so first of all, we have to understand that this is just not a normal exam. It's an exam at an all India level. So the preparation strategy is also very different for this. You have to, give your heart and soul to this exam. Like, we have three subjects, physics, chemistry, and biology. So what I used to do is, I used to study biology whenever I was free or in my free time, because biology is comparatively an easy subject. And physics and chemistry, since I attended coaching as well, so I used to do physics chemistry along with the coaching. Matlab jitna coaching mein padhaya utna ghar aake padha. So that really helps you out. So apart from this, very important thing that you have to understand is you have to be having a good diet. Not only because you have to study, but you have to have a good sleep. Good diet, everything is important. You have to take a good exercise. Everything is important.
That's nice. So not only studies, you have to take care of your routine, your diet, your sleep. All right. Shivita, you mentioned that you used to go for a coaching. So how important it is to join a coaching institute?
I think it is important to join coaching institute because, it sets you on the right track. You will do everything by yourself, but there should be somebody to guide you through the right track, what you have to do, how you have to do, how you have to prepare. And coaching not only provides you the track, but it gives you mock tests, which helps you understand that where you stand on all India level. So that is really necessary. And I took coaching when I was in class 11th and 12th. So I prepared for NEET 2 years, and then I gave the exam in one go. So what happened was, when I used to prepare in these 2 years, I really benefited the coaching part, because they have set a strategy how to, you can go through this whole journey of preparing for NEET. So coaching really matters. But there are students who can prepare without coaching, but it's all up to you. How do you feel to join the coaching? So I believe that coaching is a good option.
All right. So you have to take your own call. If you feel it's a burden on you, you are not able to manage it, it's better to prepare yourself.
It's
a good option. All right. Shivita, so did you drop a year for your preparation?
No, I didn't drop a year. I just took 11th and 12th coaching. So after that, I gave my exam and I got a good rank in one group.
So Shivita, how did you balance your school curriculum, school syllabus, school timing and school commitment with your coaching and preparation commitment? Because at times children feel it's a double burden on them.
Yeah, it is a burden actually, because in the morning you have to go to school, then when you come back in the afternoon, then you have to get ready, have lunch, and then immediately go to coaching, and then coming back at night. So it is a burden actually, but you should know how to manage this. But I think another option is there are many online coaching classes that are available. So at my time when I was doing this, I don't think any online coaching was available at that time. But I think now it is available. So students can really approach that thing. But how I used to manage was like, whenever I used to go to school, or when I'm in my bus, or whenever I have a free period in my class, I used to study biology every time. I used to keep on reading, because you know, the more you read, the more you understand. So I used to keep on reading biology, and physics and chemistry I used to solve every question when I was free. So you cannot waste your time when you are preparing for such, you know, big exams. So you have to give every minute of your life, and every minute you have to give it into this. That is how it matters.
Yeah. So it's 100% dedication to the cause.
It's 100% dedication.
So Shivita, tell, is it a good idea to drop a year?
I'm not saying that it is a bad idea, but I would say that if you have dedicated yourself into this career, if you have decided what you have to be, then why do you are thinking too late? Think early. And like, for example, when I was in class 10th, it was decided for me that I wanted to be a doctor. So my path, my road was decided that I had to do NEET, I had to do MBBS and all. So of course, I will take coaching in 11th and 12th standard, and then I got a good rank in the first go. But in case you have not decided, so there are many students who take like PCMB, and then they think that abhi le lete hain, baad mein sochenge kya hoga, jo hoga dekhenge. So it takes time to for them to understand, but finally they drop a year to prepare for NEET especially. But when they drop, I have seen most of my friends only, they got stressed, because you don't have any particular routine. You have to do everything by yourself. Phir coaching ka sara stress aa jata hai. So everything matters. And I have a friend of mine, she was with me only. And she, in the second attempt when she gave NEET, she got a even lower rank.
No.
Her rank was not good because she dropped there because of all the stress that is building upon you. But so it is totally up to you if you want to drop, if you don't want to drop. And I'm not saying that those who drop do not perform well. There are so many NEET toppers, so many toppers in AIIMS and all, who have dropped the year and given their 100%. So it definitely depends upon your strategy and how do you perform.
All right.
So
Shivita, that's very interesting. I mean, you again have to see what suits you. If you feel you'll be disciplined and dedicated to a structured routine, then by all means drop a year. And if you feel you are not going to win that battle against yourself, then I think going by the 12th and the NEET examiner same year is a better option. All right. So Shivita, just how is the life in a medical college? I mean, when those who are preparing, I'm sure many of them will make it to medical colleges. So what should they be prepared mentally to face in the future?
Yeah. So when I was preparing for NEET, I had no idea what medical college is about. And I wish somebody would have been there to tell me what it is and shown me, see, this is where you are going to. So what it is, actually, it's not exactly like a college life. Like every school going student wishes that one day we will go to college, we will be independent and all. That is all there, but all that school ka homework and every padai, everything is so much in medical college that you hardly have any time to spare, because every day you have to study, each and every single day you have to give, like, I don't know, 3 to 4 hours. Self-study is very important, but we hardly make that 3 to 4 hours. So there is a lot of studies. There is so much study, and in the evening also we sometimes go to clinic to see the patients. So there is, you know, if you really want to be in medicine, then you should have that thing in you. You should have that will so that you enjoy all this. Because if you take it as a burden, then you won't be able to go through it. So I'm not saying it's all studies. There are some good things happening in school, college as well. Like we have tests and all. We go to trips and we enjoy our college life as well. It is mostly study. So that is what it is.
All right.
You have to study a lot.
Yes. So Shivita, the last question is, share 3 best strategies for preparation for NEET exam with our students.
So first thing I would say is, whatever you are studying, give 100%. and make notes of what you're studying. Why notes is important? Because when you are revising for the exam, in the last few days of the exam or last few months of the exam, you won't be looking through your books. You cannot search your books for important things. The last few days have to be reserved for everything that is important. So make notes, revise. That is my important thing. You have to revise every time. Like, even if you, what I used to do is, I used to revise on every Sunday so that nothing goes out of my mind. So that is what you can adopt. You can adopt your strategy. You can have your way of understanding, your way of studying. So that is what I think is important. So when you are studying, start making notes for your revision, so that later on you do not open up hundreds of books and keep looking for material to revise, and last day of the exam will be like, are you reading something new? That should not be the case.
All right.